Hey everyone, Havoc here. Got a new another tank review. Gonna start my series of the American medium lines. I'm gonna start here at the T20. It's one of my favorite tanks in the entire game. It's the tier 7 American medium tank. I don't have a lot of videos before this. I'm gonna talk about the line that I took to get here and the tanks that I went through, and I'm not gonna do a full review on the tanks prior to this one. I'm just going to give you a real quick overview on how I feel about them, what I would do. I have a couple little pointers, but other than that, this is where I felt like the line really came alive for me. And as I said, it's one of my favorite tanks in the game, my favorite tier 7 medium. And we're going to get into the T20 here real quick. But like I said, real quick, I'm just going to show you guys what I did to get here. As you go down the American medium lines, I do not play the lower tiers. So if you have to grind through these, you know, good luck to you. The M3 Lee is known as one of the worst tanks in the game. I have never played the tank. I'm sure it's not nearly as bad as people say it is. But with that being said, I was trying to get through this line in kind of a hurry at the time. And I definitely wasn't going to waste time. It's one of the voted worst tanks in the game. If you guys want to play it for the memes, go for it. More power to you. I chose to go down the M4 and the Jumbo line. On my other account, I've got an E5 already, so I went down American Heavy line. The American Heavy line is amazing. I definitely recommend everyone go down that line if you're into heavy tanks. And even if you're not into heavy tanks, if you're going to have a heavy tank, that's one of the heavy tanks to own. T1 Heavy, M6 are absolutely unbelievable. But in this case, I went down the M4 and Jumbo line because I wanted to not only go down the American Medium lines, but to unlock the T29 and get started. If I decide that I do want an E5 on this account, then maybe I guess I'd have to be bored in the future. It's really not a plan at all of mine, but just in case, I decided to do the Jumbo because it would start me down the path for both the heavy and the medium tank for American. I've never done the EZ8. I'm sure it's a great tank. I don't know much about it. But if you want to unlock both those lines, you're going to go down the line that I went through right here. So M4, Jumbo, very similar tanks as far as how they look and their guns. One of the biggest differences between the two is the E2 has incredible armor for its tier. The M4 is more like a medium. It is a Sherman. Great gun, really no armor. Both of these tanks I would use gun rammer, GLD, and vents. Just put all your strength towards the gun. As far as crew skills, it's just really early on when you're talking about tier 5 and tier 6. I don't anticipate that you'd have a lot of crew skills, but if you do, I would go, obviously, Sixth Sense, number one, Brothers in Arms, and, you know, since the Jumbo plays so much like a heavy, you might want to do repairs, but once you get up to here, the T20 and on in this line, you're going to want to maximize your view range and your camo skills, because that's what this line is all about. Anyone who's going to go down the American Medium line should know that the American mediums have a 10 meter view range advantage over any other tanks in the game at every tier. So starting, I know starting here at tier 7, you're going to have 10 meters view range more than any other tank at tier 7. And that goes on down the line to the tier 10. So obviously you want to maximize your strengths in this game. I felt like it was important to go with situational awareness and recon as soon as possible, especially when you get to the tier 10. But also, spotting in this game is a mixture between camouflage and view range. So if you don't have good camo value, as you will find out when you get to the tier 10, the M48 Patton has terrible camo value, but it also has the best view range in the game. No other tank has 420 meters of view range. So it's a weird mixture, but that being said, having such a bad camo value, it does cause you to get outspotted even with the best view range in the game. So I would recommend going camouflage and then situational awareness or vice versa, and then after you get both of those skills, you could go to recon. With the T20, you're going to see that I'll talk about the crew skills more with the T20, but I told you about the equipment for the M4, the E2. Here's the one little tip I want to show you with the E2. We're going to talk about the armor here real quick. This armor is really, really sick as far as the plate goes. Actually, here, I'm just going to go right into this. If you were to first just jump down this line, you had no information at all, you would say, well, I want to unlock the T20 and the T29. So in order to do that, I got to go here, and then these two tanks will be unlocked from this package right here. If you wanted to improve on the tank a little bit more, you're like, oh, here, I'll get the Apex, the best package there is available. And this has the best turret, best gun, best everything. I'm going to get this package. But actually, if you look at this lower branch, it's there for a reason. And seeing as you're going to have to do probably roughly 100,000 XP in this tank, you're going to be in there for a while, you might want to get the best tank possible. And I don't feel like this is the best package possible. If you look down here on this lower branch, the differences between the two is the turret. Well, clearly this is the tier 6 turret, so it's better. And it is better in respect to the gun. You're going to have more accuracy and a better rate of fire, which is awesome. But if you look at the turret armor, it's 64 millimeters of turret armor. Then you go down to this branch down here to the tier 5 turret, and it's 152 millimeters of turret armor all the way around. 152 millimeters of turret armor at tier 6. This is like the IS-7 of tier 6. I mean, that is an incredible amount of turret armor for a tier 6 tank. Yes, you're going to lose a little bit in the gun. You're going to have that 0.43 accuracy instead of the 0.40 with the better turret. And your rate of fire does actually change significantly. I mean, 4 rounds a minute. But it's to have that defensive ability is unbelievable. And when you look at the tank, the armor profile, like you already have quite an upper plate here at an angle. This upper plate is very powerful. You're bouncing shots all day long. Now throw on this incredible turret, and you're quite a force. This tank is a medium, like a Super Pershing is a medium at tier 8. It has the medium insignia, but it plays like a heavy. As a matter of fact, it probably bounces more shells than most of the heavies at tier 6, with the exception of maybe some of the Russian stuff. So I just want to talk about that with the M4 and the E2 just to get you on your way. And now we're going to go to the T20, one of my favorite tanks in the game. I've said that before. And I talked to you about crew skills, Sixth Sense, Brothers in Arms, situational awareness or camouflage, depending on what order you want to do it in, and then recon, maximize that view range, and then I would go to the gun skills, because looking at the gun, it's one of the greatest guns in the game, my favorite tier 7 medium tank in the game, my favorite tier 7 medium gun in the game. 0.38 accuracy is not bad. 2.3 aim time is pretty much standard in the game. The rate of fire is a little low, and I know some people complain about that with this tank. They're like, oh, the rate of fire is so low, because they're coming off of 75 millimeters in tier 5 and 6. You're used to smaller guns that shoot rapidly. This is a 240 alpha damage gun at tier 7. That's a big alpha. That's a 90 millimeter gun. That's a gun you normally see on tier 8 mediums, and you're seeing it at tier 7. So I love the gun. I love the gun on top of the fact that you're already in a tank with very good camo value, the top view range in the game. So you're already an amazing scout with a great gun. Yeah, you don't have any armor. I would say this tank reminds me of a tier 7 Leopard, because it's not exactly, I mean, you have armor. It's just not likely to work, because, like, if you look at the best armor on the tank is the turret, and that, I mean, it seems like it would work, but it's so flat. It's definitely easily penetrated. And the upper plate, you have armor again. If it's an errant shot hitting you off at like an angle like this, you might get some bounces. But the point is you're not going to play this tank hoping to bounce any shells. You're not going to get hull down or anything like that. You don't want to be seen, and if you're seen, you're basically going to run away. You have the mobility and the camo value and the view range to be a great scout and compete with light tanks. And on top of that, unlike a light tank, though, you have a gun that does real damage. So that's why I love this tank so much. I'm going to show you some gameplay, some great scouting, and the usage of the gun. The gun, like I said, it's such a great gun at this tier. It can do incredible amounts of damage for a tier 7 tank. Looking at the supplies, this tank has a 20% chance of firing the engine, but I still ran Cola. I caught on fire a lot, but it definitely has an engine that's prone to fire. So this is pretty daring of me, and I know that. But if you want to run a fire extinguisher instead, I completely understand, and I don't blame you one bit. As far as shells go, plenty of shells on board. So you decide to do however you want. It does see tier 9 tanks. And with tier 9 armor, I definitely chose to have a lot of APCR on board. Doesn't mean you have to fire it all, but because you have such a high shell count, I mean, I have 28 AP, 14 APCR, and this is probably a lot of HE, but the HE's got, like, okay pen. So, I mean, you could do less if you want, but it's the point being is there's plenty of shells on board. You pick the mixture that works best for you. Just remember that you could get in a tier 9 game, and in a tier 9 game, you're going to want to fire a lot of APCR, or at least I do. So that's crew skills we talked about. We talked about supplies just now and equipment real quick. Yeah, pretty standard. I'm going to do gun rammer, vertical stabilizer. Those are staples in all my mediums. And then I do coated optics. And then on top of the fact that I'm running a premium consumable for all maximum crew skills, it's a done deal. Okay. Not much more to say. I'm going to let the gameplay do the talking here. As I said, it's basically a scout with a great gun. And the gameplay will show you that one of my favorite tanks in the game. And I'll see you guys out there. Thanks.
Oh, only two yardies in there, 5 and 4.
Oh, you got UN guys, React Wall and React Riot. They're good players.
The enemy knows our location. Releasing target. Loaded and ready.
Yep.
Enemy exposed. Ready to fire on target.
Arty's gone. One Arty's gone. Oh. You guys are gonna shoot the Spoilermaker. Please tell me everybody's gonna shoot the Spoilermaker. Okay. Well, I just went up there and nothing did anything to me, so. This Chaffee's gonna come in here, dude. Like, he's full blown.
Target locked. I see one.
Oh, the Hellcat is just YOLOing. I don't know why.
They destroyed one of our tanks. Target locked.
Oh, I tracked the Challenger and. Get away, he repaired it right away. Oh, the grill just hit me. Fuck.
Why can't I light the grill?
Ready to fire on target. Penetration. Gun loaded.
It's dude, if that light take is gone, it's a shooting spree.
Ready to fire on target. They've spotted us. Ready to fire. Focus attention here.
Ooh, somebody hit the Chaffee.
The enemy knows our location.
I got him! I got him, boys! Hot damn! Already put a shot up there. Alright, now I'm gonna get up in this bush to your right, and I am going to spot. You can come up here with me if you'd like. Look at this. In the bush. Completely in. You're about to see everything get lit. Their whole team is lit. Another round of lights.
She's loaded.
Here we go.
Target locked.
Oh, ow, ow, ow. Ow, I got hit. An O knee? Where do you put an O knee? How could I not see an O knee? I do have better view range than... Oh, there's an Oni. I do have better view range than anything else in this game, right? I can't believe we let the Oni get away. That sucks, dude.
Reloaded.
Sucks bad. Oh. What's this?
Ready to fire on
target. Oh, it's a goddamn Challenger.
Oh,
and he's cracked, too.
Scratch another bad guy. Target locked.
I gotta find him, dude. Oh, we got the Oni coming on the right hand side. Alright, just, I'm just gonna go get, go, go, oh, there he is, there he is, there he is.
Ready to fire on target. Look out, enemy spotted.
Alright, I'm gonna fall back into some, well, no, I'm gonna stay in the bush, but I'm just gonna stay over here. So I got Saint Emile. The two UN guys are good. So they have avoided this whole section. Somebody should go cap, maybe?
Focus on this area.
Artie? Shit, dude, I'm lit.
We've got a lock. Ready to fire.
Oh no, there's a tank waiting for him on cap.
Target locked. Good clean hit.
I tracked him. No, Apple Banana Monkey needs to stay alive. Oh no, that last shot I fired, I didn't need to fire that. Uh-oh. Where's the other?
Locked and loaded.
Are you, no, it's, I don't think it is.
Friendly vehicle destroyed. Looks like that one went right through.
This SU or whatever is gonna come over here, it looks like. Oh wait, I'll hop in the 1-2 line. You think I can get there? I can't save them both. I gotta reset cap. I gotta see who's on cap to stop the capping. Oh shit.
Oh, fuck. I just got lit, yeah. So now the SU knows where I am.
All Allied artillery has been obliterated. Enemy armor is damaged.
No. But I will be.
That one drilled straight through.
When that SU gets down here. Should I worry about him shooting Tracer or just keep firing?
Nice shot.
It's not lit anymore. Yeah, I just realized that. The AT is really out of ammo? Uh-oh.
Target locked.
I'm gonna let these guys rush the AT. Bounced him, dude. Fuck.
Loaded and ready.
I got the shit really turned up on this thing.
Locked on. We've been detected.
Of course.
Reloaded.
Well, that wasn't, I guess it's not a cold, so.
Focus on this location.
Cap? Yeah, no problem.
They found us. Dropping target.
Oh shit. Oh shit, here it comes.
Bail out. This vehicle has had it.
Like, where do I go? You know, it's like, where do I go? Needless to say, it was a nice tech here, but it's robbed of my fool's medal, which I have yet to get. But their heavy tanks really pushed up hard against that ditch. I think they wanted to go there. Could have been a different game if they had gotten in there. Oh, back to nines. Good, good. Maybe we should go spot the middle where Fallen would go. That's what I'll do.
Either have to take them all out or capture their base. Let's roll.
Well, you can go there too, but you're not really much for scouting, are you? I didn't think you were. That's why I said I should probably go there. I normally go the same place every time on this map, but I'm a little concerned. Tier 9s. That may not work out. You're a tank destroyer on this map. Yeah, it's pretty simple. You just kind of pick the base and slam. I just tracked the Conqueror. Everybody wants to.
Punched a hole in their armor.
Oh.
The waffle?
Ready to fire on target.
Hiya, hiya.
Focus attention here. Locked and loaded.
Oh shit. Oh shit, shit, shit. A lot of lights here.
Ready to fire on target.
Fuck.
Been detected.
I'm gonna try and. I just tracked it. What?
It's like we're shooting spitballs. Enemies got us in their sights. That's what gotta hurt. Track is good to go. Target locked.
Oh, you're out of ammo, aren't you?
We got him. Enemy down.
Is he really? Where is he? Get him. This gun, when you don't have premium, when you're out of premium rounds, you're fucked. So it's an Oskins medal. Medium tanker destroys 3 enemy tanks or tank destroyers. The targets must be 2 tier higher than them. Well, there are going to be non-super unicums playing this tank, and they're not going to be as good as I am. He said it's also just the test server, and he's like, the, you know, people will figure this tank out and stuff like that. It's not going to be necessarily the end of the world.
It's like we're shooting spitballs.
Oh no.
Target locked. That's gotta hurt. Looks like that one went right.
You're lucky. They are just a team full of retards down there.
She's loaded.
We are against a team of just fucking morons. It's awesome. It's awesome! They are like the stupidest team of all time. This is so cool. Oh, you're dead. This is the part on sprockets when we dance.
Focus on this location. They found us. Looks like that one went right through. Gun loaded. Enemy is here.
Now is the time on sprockets when we dance. Doesn't feel like a victory here, but in a way it is.
on target. Scratch another bad guy. Gotta hurt.